Hi guys, welcome to another video from God's Reporter. I'd like to welcome you to watch me today. Today we're talking about hatred of our enemies. But first I'd like to start off with a prayer, and I'd like to thank all of you for sending the prayer request. I hope you keep them coming, and if you can, video your testimony and send it to me. I would love to put it on the show. If you have a webcam on your computer or have someone video you with your cell phone, no problem. Just email it to me at godsreporter01@gmail.com and I'd be happy to review it and put it on the show. Also, keep sending your prayer requests and send me praises. Send me things God has done in your life. People would love to know about these things. People know that God is great, and they want to know what He's doing in people's lives. Today, though, we're going to talk about the enemies we have in our life, and instead of hatred, we need to be praying for them. Let's start off with a prayer. Father God, thank you for today. Thank you for the opportunity for me to come and share your word again across the United States and the world. I hope and pray that someone will hear these words and it will reach their hearts. I pray for Deborah today, Lord. She wrote me and you know her needs, Lord. Pray that you will touch her life, wrap your arms around her and her family, Lord. Give them comfort and peace. And thank you for all the viewers that watch me. I hope they're watching to hear your word and not my voice. Thank you, Jesus. In your precious name I pray. Amen. Okay, today our video is on Psalms chapter 41. So I'd like for you to hear this, please.
Psalm 41. To the choir master, a psalm of David. Blessed is the one who considers the poor. In the day of trouble, the Lord delivers him. The Lord protects him and keeps him alive. He is called blessed in the land. You do not give him up to the will of his enemies. The Lord sustains him on his sickbed. In his illness, you restore him to full health. As for me, I said, O Lord, be gracious to me. Heal me, for I have sinned against you. My enemies say of me in malice,
when will he die and his name perish?
And when one comes to see me, he utters empty words while his heart gathers iniquity. When he goes out, he tells it abroad. All who hate me whisper together about me. They imagine the worst for me. They say, a deadly thing is poured out on him. He will not rise again from where he lies. Even my close friend in whom I trusted, who ate my bread, has lifted his heel against me. But you, O Lord, be gracious to me and raise me up that I may repay them. By this I know that you delight in me. My enemy will not shout in triumph over me. But you have upheld me because of my integrity and set me in your presence forever. Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel, from everlasting to everlasting. Amen and amen.
Psalm 42. To the choir master, a maskil of the sons of...
Now, do you understand what they were talking about? They say their enemies are their closest friends sometimes. Sometimes our friends say things to our faces. We are great, you know. It's awesome to have you as friends, you know. But then they go behind our backs and say how bad they think we are. But hatred is not the answer. Just because they may hate us, we're not supposed to hate back. We need to pray for our enemies. Pray that God will touch their hearts They don't understand how or why we're Christians sometimes. They may be Christians, but not going through the Christian way. But pray, we need to pray for all our enemies. We need to talk to them about God. Tell them God's word. They may not listen. You never know. But if we don't at least try, we're no better than they are. We can't hate back. Hatred is like a fuel on the fire. The more hatred we have for them and they have for us, the worse it gets. It doesn't get any better. But pray for our enemies, our friends, our closest friends, our family. If you want to worry about less things in the world, pray more about everything. God listens to all things. But if you have any comments or suggestions you'd like to send me about things that I've been talking about on videos, feel free to email me at godsreporter01@gmail.com or message me on my Facebook page, God's Reporter. I'd love to hear it, and maybe we could have a discussion on the video. But people don't, just because we may be going through a bad time, they may turn their backs on us. And instead of helping us out, they just would rather walk away. That's when we need to pray for them and ask God to touch their hearts. I'd much rather have a friend with God than have a friend that will talk about me behind my back. Misery loves company, as the old saying says. If they're probably miserable about something in their life, so they'd rather have somebody make somebody else miserable in their life and have them join them. But God, praying to God is the only answer. Prayer is the answer, not hatred. We should love all people, no matter what they do. Instead of hating them back and going after them, we need to pray for them, teach them God's word. We need to share the word, go out. That's why the world is in the shape that it's in now. No one wants to talk about God's word. No one wants to get outside the walls of the church or the walls of their house. They don't want to get out in the world and tell about God. Jesus is the only answer. He is the only answer. Jesus, God is the true love. If you don't have God in your heart, you don't know true love. I'm not one to sugarcoat things. God doesn't want me to sugarcoat it. Satan wants it sugarcoated. He wants the world full of hatred and chaos, and then he wants to sugarcoat it and put it, you know, is it as great as it is? But it's not great. Not without God. If you don't have God, you have nothing. So if you want to talk to me about Jesus, and maybe I can help you accept Jesus into your heart, I'd be happy to. It would be awesome to talk to someone about them being saved. Send me a letter. Email me. Message me on Facebook. I'd love to hear it. And I would share it on the air if you wanted me to. That's what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to teach people how to be a normal Christian. Years ago, there was no problem going out into the world and telling people about Jesus. It was no problem going to a store and saying, God bless you. It was no problem going to a friend's house and saying Jesus loves you, or going to the store and telling a perfect stranger Jesus loves you. That's the answer. That's the answer to all things. You know, philosophers used to say, what's the meaning of life? If you're a Christian, you should know that answer right off the bat. That should be the easiest thing in the world. Christians know Jesus is the meaning of life. Nothing else matters. I'm a Christian. I'm proud to be a Christian. I'll tell you I'm a Christian right off the bat, no matter what situation I'm in. God defends me. He protects me, and He'll protect you. Let Jesus into your heart. He's the greatest thing in the world. People say that being a Christian is old-fashioned, that God doesn't care anymore, that we're closed-minded. We worship the one true God, the God that created the universe. How much more open-minded can you get? There is no other God but Jesus. Buddha is not a god. Allah is not a god. You know, Muhammad is not a god. They were all men. That's it. Jesus walked the earth in the form of a man, but he was God. He is God, and he is alive today. Send me a letter. Send me a request. Tell me what I'm doing wrong if you think I'm doing something wrong. I'd be glad to hear from you. Thank you for joining me today. And remember, God loves you. Don't hate. Love all. God bless you and have a great weekend. Thanks for joining me.